Hey everyone, today I am repurposing this tray that I found at my parents' farm in Montana. It's a pretty cool antique tray. I'm just gonna assume it's from the 1970s, as almost everything that I get from their farmhouse is from the 1970s. So the tray actually comes off the top, so it's a nice serving tray. Here, the first step, I guess, is to take it apart. So this had nice bolts on the back. It was very secure. Wasn't easy to loosen those bolts up. The wheels are easily detached. They just slip on and off. Not sure exactly what I'm looking at. Maybe my neighbor was doing something, or maybe my daughter was talking to me here, but the tray was in pretty good condition. It was strong. It's just the top tray. My mom said that she left a plant on it and it leaked, and over time it just rusted out. Well, let's be truthful. The yellow's cute, but I wanted to update it just a little bit, so. All right, now that I got it all taken apart, I am putting everything on the table. As you can see, it just slipped right off. The wheels were really easy to remove. Now that I got on the table, the most important thing was to clean it. So I took some time and I cleaned it all up with a rag. And here you're gonna see that I am sanding it. The most important part about painting anything is the prep that you put into it. So every surface needs to be clean, dull, dry, and sound. So right here, I'm dulling it. So just abrading the surface is gonna help anything stick to the top. Then I'm gonna come through, and the handles on the tray, they were installed with a pop pin, so I wasn't able to remove those. I do prefer, when I'm restoring a project, to remove everything, to bring it down as far as I can, take everything apart and put it back together. But I use edge lock tape. Yes, 3M edge lock tape is a little bit more pricey, but it doesn't leave a funky residue, and it just makes everything really, that the edges are just a lot more clean. So you can see right there, I put a piece of tape over that, and you're going to see me come back and cut around the tape, around the handle, so the tape is nice and tight, so it shapes that handle really nice. Here I am cutting that. Probably pushing the tape around it. I want to make sure it's nice and tight, as you can see. Alright, time to do the other side. Pretty picky when I do these projects, so I like to show people in real time. How long it actually takes to do these projects. Even though it's a quick project, it did take me a couple hours to get it done. Most of that being dry time was the actual paint itself. So as you can see, that spot, that was a pretty big rust spot. I have to tell you, before I left Montana, I actually used a wire grinder and I ground that down as much as I can. just to make it all smooth. You don't want to paint over rust, so that was the main purpose. I just removed all the rust on that big old spot on the tray itself. So, all right, now I should be winding that up. All right, I got the handles all masked off, so now it's time to put the tools away because it's important to stay as clean and organized as possible. I hate hunting for tools in the project. Anybody that knows me knows it drives me crazy when I can't find something because it wasn't put away. All right, so now I'm going to use Krylon Paint and Primer 1. This is an interior exterior. This is iron rubbed metallic. So when I spray, the one thing that I've learned is that you don't stop on the actual. So you overshoot it every time, and thin coats is always better than just sitting there spraying on it. So you don't want to get runs. So just keep on spraying side to side, overshooting it back and forth. It may take a little while to spray it all to make sure you have a good coverage. That is important as well. I have to tell you right now, this is drying wickedly fast on me. It was probably about 90 degrees in Georgia, and the humidity, oh man, it looks like I am working. I'm sweating. Yes, you can see I have a nice glow on my skin. So it's not ideal painting, but yeah, it worked. So it takes a while to paint. I love painting. Painting has always been just a love of mine. I love how it can restore any item. And I'm hoping this brings back to life. If this doesn't hold up, it is Krylon enamel. If it doesn't hold up, I am going to possibly resand it back down. And then I'm going to use a metal primer and then come back with another enamel top coat. And possibly, if I'm getting really crazy, if I just want to make sure, I would top coat it with a clear enamel. So yeah, that's a three-step coating process. So we'll see how this holds up. It will take approximately maybe a week to cure this product. A lot of products dry really quick to touch, but it doesn't mean it is at its full strength. So we'll see. We'll find out through the process. Again, I love painting, so I'm willing to try it. This is more of a quick paint job for me, but if it doesn't work, I'll just send it all off and do a three coat system. Primer is important for adhesion, but this says it's a paint and primer one. Sometimes I have luck with these products, and sometimes I just need to go a lot more durable. Yep, you can see I'm using a spray can, but if I do want to go to a more durable product, I can use my HVOP sprayer, and that's going to give it a nice smooth finish on this, but this spray can, it worked out great, so it looks great. I just, I always get a little nervous when I use a spray can on the quality of the product, so it just really depends if it actually holds up. This does take me a little bit to spray this out, so there is going to be a little silence in this video. I love watching people paint, so it doesn't bother me just to sit here and watch this all go down. When you got what you want, baby, I should So I do kind of go in as I see. The most important thing about painting is to have an even top coat layer. And so some parts will be a little thinner, and you don't want that because you can kind of see through it. So I want to make sure I have a good, nice, even coat, keeping it light. And being very thorough and taking your time through the whole project. You can see this was quick though. I mean, this video isn't very long. Alright, now as it is all drying, I have to run to Home Depot. I needed screws. It was missing one of the original screws. So I had a nice guy from Home Depot help me find that screw that I'm missing. And then I wanted to clean these wheels as good as I could. They're a little old. I'll use some WD-40 and make sure they're all greased inside, but I wanted to make sure everything was super clean, as, yeah, it's gonna be in my house. So I flipped it over and painted the other side because I want to make sure it's thorough. Here's the final project. And this is what it looks like all set up. Pretty cute, huh?